Hey guys, Anjali here. You may remember me from my prior blog post about knee recovery. To get those of you who don't know me up to speed, I'm a kinesiology student currently at the University of British Columbia. I'm currently on a co-op term here at West Coast SCI. To get right into things, I'm super passionate about the realm of physiology, which is essentially the study of how our body functions. I'm currently enrolled in a class called Exercise Physiology. This branch of physiology discusses how our body responds and adapts to physical activity throughout our lives. I find our bodies incredibly interesting and love learning about how our body systems run and function each day. For this reason, I'll be providing you guys with podcasts based on what I am learning in topics that I think could help you guys understand how our bodies work and how exercise affects it. My first topic for today will be on energy expenditure. I will discuss how your caloric intake and output specifically affect your daily energy expenditure. Now, these terms may seem a little unfamiliar right now, so let me break them down for you. So, energy expenditure is essentially how much energy your body is using during each task it undergoes in the daily. Our total daily energy expenditure is impacted by three general factors. These three factors are 1, the thermogenic effect of feeding, 2, thermic effect of physical activity, and 3, your resting metabolic rate. So the first component, which is thermogenic effect of feeding, takes up about 10% of our total daily energy expenditure. This has to do with the fact that when we consume food, we must transfer the energy from that food into something our bodies can store. This is like when we store our carbs in our bread and convert it to glycogen or fat in our bodies. Energy transfer in our body is quite inefficient, so heat is produced with each energy transfer and therefore takes up energy. So the second component, which is thermic effect of physical activity, takes up about 15 to 30% of our daily energy expenditure, and this would include all things physical you do in the day. This includes getting up from bed in the morning, walking downstairs, walking to work, playing sports, or getting a workout in. The last and largest component, which is your resting metabolic rate, which is RMR for short, would take up about 60 to 75% of our total daily energy expenditure. So this is the bulk of where our energy goes in the day. Resting metabolic rate refers to the amount of energy our body burns during rest, which also depicts how effective your body's metabolism is. This is more easily explained as the number of calories our body burns per day if you were to do absolutely nothing but sit. RMR focuses on our fat-free body mass, which is our body's lean body mass, including water, organs, and muscle. So basically everything in your body except for fat. Your RMR is also dependent on your gender and things like your thyroid hormones and protein turnover rate. Resting metabolic rate is often used in unison with the term basal metabolic rate. Basal metabolic rate is similarly the amount of energy needed to sustain vital functions in the waking state. It usually possesses a slightly lower value than resting metabolic rate and is measured in more specific conditions, including having no prior physical activity before taking the test. Nonetheless, resting metabolic rate and basal metabolic rate both help us view an individual's calories burned in the day in order to help us develop weight maintenance, gain, or loss strategies. So, resting metabolic rate varies in context to the size of our bodies. This is in context to the square of body surface area per hour. As mentioned before, resting metabolic rate varies in gender. So females usually have about 5 to 15% lower BMR or RMR than males who are the same age. This is due to the naturally less fat-free mass on women's bodies. So now that I gave you guys a background on daily energy expenditure and resting and basal metabolic rate, I can give you guys some cool advice. So in this class, after reading the article The Exercise Paradox by Herman Ponser and taking into consideration the knowledge learned in this energy module, I would like to provide you guys with some scientific evidence on the correct way to lose weight. So you've probably heard the phrase, you can't out-exercise a bad diet. Now, I wonder if anyone's ever told you the real reason why. I myself had believed that phrase for years, but never quite understood why. So as you may know, 1 pound is equivalent to the total of 3,500 calories. Our bodies burn a certain number of calories through resting metabolic rate, as I previously mentioned. The average person eats about the same number of calories as calculated in their resting metabolic rate and use that as their maintenance calories to maintain the current weight that they're at. So that's basically like consuming the same amount of calories as you burn in a day to put you at a baseline. That being said, it's clearly seen that to lose weight, you must have a lower caloric intake than your metabolic rate. And to gain weight, you must consume a higher caloric intake than the calories calculated for your metabolic rate. In this case, most of you guys will think if you burn a bunch of calories at the gym every day and continue to eat at or above your maintenance, you'll still lose weight. This is for those of you who like to eat excessive junk food and say you'll work it off at the gym. Well, I got some fun facts for you. Our bodies are pretty smart about what they put their energy towards. Some insightful facts that I learned through this module was that individuals of all different physical abilities require roughly the same amount of energy, whether they're relatively sedentary and sit on the couch all day, or they work out really often and are very active. So even if you do work out consistently, the overall daily expenditure difference is only around 200 calories from someone who doesn't work out. The reason for this is because our bodies shift in accordance to our needs. So if we increase our energy expenditure through physical activity, we don't see a total energy expenditure increase during the day that is proportional to the amount we calculated during physical activity. So if you burn an extra 300 calories in your workout, it's not really going to have effect on the actual daily energy expenditure. This is because our bodies have essential energy expenditure, which is like metabolizing the nutrients we have, our carbs, fats, proteins, and we also have non-essential energy expenditure. So these are processes our body undergoes that we don't actually need, but it's still put energy towards. When we exercise consistently, our bodies will start to put less energy towards these negative processes in the body, such as inflammation or chronic diseases. So to be more specific, our bodies might be at risk for a chronic disease, but when we increase our physical activity, our total daily energy expenditure decreases these negative processes. So this puts you back at a baseline metabolic rate, as the calories that used to go towards these non-essential processes now goes to our physical activity. Theoretically, the physical activity will not act as extra calories burned above our maintenance calories. On the other hand, if we are overworking our bodies, so this is by exercising too often in a day per week, this may decrease our essential energy processes. This is seen for Olympic level women athletes who actually lose their menstrual cycle due to excessive training. So that would have been an essential process that is now not able to undergo because our body doesn't have enough energy to put towards that. So the overall aim of this podcast was to explain that our bodies are pretty smart with shifting where it puts its energy. If you would like to lose weight, you must be in a caloric deficit in the foods you consume in a day. So you can calculate your maintenance calories, and then you can also calculate a caloric deficit that over time will allow you to lose a pound or whatever your goal is. So this over time results in weight loss. On the other hand, it is possible to lose weight with exercise, but it's really much harder. This may also put our bodies at more risk for the level of training it would need to lose pounds. Like I said, shifting to having our essential processes stop working. So overall, exercising is key for keeping your bodies healthy, keeping your heart healthy. But to lose weight, it primarily relates to the amount of food you consume in the day. I found this topic super interesting to learn, and I hope you all did as well. Thanks for listening, and I'll see you guys next time.